destination. Enjoy your stay. To a party at Huntbreakers before. Chikara has a bit of a crush on her, you know. Just watch. He'll be too nervous to even talk to her.
Fancy meeting you here, boss.
We were catching up with Theron and Lana, and they mentioned you were here. Figured we'd lend a hand.
We've cut a few deals with these people over the years. With our help, you'll know just how to play them. They'll vote however you want.
If you already know these people, why don't you handle the negotiations?
All of the deals we've cut were small time compared to this. Convincing them to fuel up Republic warships will take some clout.
Dealing with someone big and important like you feeds people's egos, makes them easier to win over. You're definitely the one for this job.
If you're ready, let's head inside. All right, first up, Huntbreaker. Revolutionary leader, liberator, and unofficial queen of Mech Sha. Her crew runs the main docks.
She won't need much convincing. Selling that fuel will bring in a small fortune, but that only stands if you keep the peace. You get too messy with any of these gangs, Huntbreakers will lock things down, no matter how much she stands to make. Keeping Mech Sha safe is her top priority.
All right. Darth Sha said that one of the crew leaders is a Republic sympathizer. What can you tell me?
Junker Jot, retired Republic Navy. His people handle maintenance for all of Mech Sha. They're the reason we've got air to breathe and a nice view that doesn't kill us.
Jot doesn't really have a crew, just droids and other engineers like him. But without them, this place literally doesn't work. So they get a seat at the table. Needless to say, the Republic will get his vote to refuel, so no need to get involved there. Better to focus on the other crew leaders.
Why bother with the others? Huntbreakers and Jot will vote in the Republic's favor. We tell the brothers to do the same, and we have a majority.
The brothers' relationship with the Empire is no secret. If they suddenly vote to sell fuel to the Republic, it will seem way too suspicious.
Yeah, it's more of a hassle, but you'll need a vote from one of the other crew leaders to keep the Republic from looking too closely.
First is Veet the Snake. He runs a Rodian smuggling ring, the Harito Wald. One of the biggest operations in the galaxy.
Veek's a businessman. He can be anybody's friend if there's an upshot for him. Just have to figure out what he needs and make sure he gets it. The other crew leader is Indigo. Mandalorian. Well, ex-Mandalorian. Same with his crew. They're called something like
Darmanda. They're mercs and gunrunners. Indigo has some kind of rivalry with Veek, so it's a good thing you only need one of them to vote your way.
Veek or Indigo. Simple enough. Thank you for your help.
What are friends for?
Looks like Huntbreakers about to give her big welcome speech. Let's find a good spot.
Mech Sha! How are you doing tonight? Look at us! We are surviving! We are thriving! We are turning this tiny rock into the beating heart of the galaxy! Just a few years ago, we were slaves. Now, we're masters. Imagine what we can become in just a few more years. All we've got to do is stay us. Be what we've been so far. We keep the peace, we keep the balance, and we keep moving forward. We've got the whole galaxy laid out in front of us. Everyone else just doesn't see it yet. All they see are the soldiers, politicians, Sith, Jedi! All the people who think they run things, who think their wars decide who's in charge. The truth is, they'll never be in charge. They'll never really run things. You know why? Because while they're busy killing each other, we're making deals, making friends, expanding! Everything they buy so they can blow each other up. We're selling and getting richer, stronger! By the time they stop and do the math, it will be too late. Because there will be a lot more of us than there are of them. And then, it will be us calling the shots. So stay the course, my friends. It only gets better from here! Welcome to Meksha. Did you enjoy the speech?
I think the Empire might not be so easy to overcome.
Time will tell. In the meantime, enjoy our hospitality. Have a drink on me, and keep the peace. You can keep the peace, yes? I have your Sith friend's word on it.
The Sith aren't known for keeping their word or keeping the peace.
Such cynicism! Commander, meet Tawidir, Jedi Knight. Enough. The two of us have a prior appointment, I'm afraid. Please, enjoy the auction.
I know you helped Malgus on Ossus. You picked the wrong side. And you're going to regret it.
I'm going to remind you of this moment when you're busy dying at my feet.
I'm not. Afraid of you.
Master Jedi.
See you around.
Feeling a bit better now?
Point. Let me return the favor. I'm looking for some help. Interested?
You think Darmanda want to fight and die in your little war? You're out of your mind. We're doing just fine on Meksha.
I'm here to get your help with our operations on Meksha. No fighting needed.
Interesting. Depending on the details. Look, this isn't a good place to do business. Too many years. Maybe they can't handle that, and we'll see.
Que faculdade ou bora geotocaquice? De monte que caça do bonilis de outro. Chai con cunta chichai.
It depends on how well you treat your friends.
Ma que puna male tuta, o nishka. Conchita chichakta. Kusa mala chikuta, I kosa mose ala tuta. Koba ne puta, taise jeskusku.
I'm curious, what's your stance on fueling the Republic ships?
Kasu yali koyaran kenka kurum. Please kataka, yos osku uko pokuta. Makipuna mali tuta, on mishka. Bitisa roda, kopana cha porko utman gisa?
It'd be better to discuss this in private.
Bampaula kavaji otto.
What do you have in mind?
Chupula wa michadesula. Kastu undile. Gio hola lukuta. Tungi machechu. Kuti nankihe. Wanawa de blotto wichawa.
And I got nothing to say to imp lovers.
Have you learned everything you need to complete our plan?
Yes, I'm done here.
Splendid. I hope your time was illuminating.
How'd I do? Too scruffy? Just scruffy enough?
Scruffy isn't the word I choose.
I couldn't agree more.
Gonna do a hit and run on Jot's turf a bit later. Need to keep the old crank from realizing who's behind it. Just need a few more sets of gear for the rest of my boys and we'll be off.
I've rather loudly let the actual Nova Blades, as well as the Exchange, hear that I'm hiring extra muscle. Word should spread quickly.
I'm on my way to meet with one of the crews we need to vote for the refueling.
Wonderful. My master knew you were the one for the job. Well then, we all have our tasks before us. Shall we reconvene in the Brothers' territory later?
Feeling a bit better now? medical attention. Be well.
Showed up. I prefer doing business here. Better drinks, no dress code. Industrial waste disposal in the back if there's trouble.
Let's pick up where we left off at the party.
Well, let's start here. What exactly do you want from me?
I want you to vote in favor of selling fuel to the Republic.
You want them to refuel? I don't know what your game is, but I don't need to. You know how this works. You do a little something for me first, and I'll consider it.
What did you have in mind?
You know that slimy little Rhodian Vink? Runs a smuggling crew? He's been raising prices on me, and I'm sick of it. Profits are thin enough without that bug-eyed scammer button in. I want him and his bodyguards dead. No witnesses. No chance the Darmanda gets the blame. I know the guy is next in line. Done business together. He'll hire some of my guys as bodyguards and I'll be in a nice spot. So, there it is. Take out Vic, and the vote's yours.
You can count on me. Vic is as good as dead.
Take this communicator and get somewhere out of the way. Buzz Vic with it, and he'll think Hutbreaker's calling for him. Use it to call me when the job's done. Once I see it with my own eyes, we'll be golden.
Ready for departure. Enjoy your stay.
Santo Crispa.
Guglielmo Wumba, FIFA Garuba Ut Juba Greta One.
Harita World once. There were a few issues, but they paid on time.
Tisa Roda, Copana Chaporgo Utman Gisa? Monkey Ki Ato Chan Kampat Noka, Chisa Bicha!
Yours. Good luck with your war.
If you tell anyone about this, you won't live to regret it. Understand?
I can keep a secret if you can.
Commander, am I interrupting anything?
I just finished convincing Indigo to support our plan. What do you need?
Perfect. Remember when I mentioned that hit and run on Jot's territory earlier? Well, I've got my squad ready to move. Last thing we need is you.
What do you mean?
Jot's crew handles maintenance for everything in the station, including the failsafe system that roasts the fuel. He'll have a schematic for the failsafe on his computers. We need that data so we can modify the system to juice it up like the boss wants. My team hits Jot's place first, so he thinks pirates are trying to run off with some of his repair droids. While he's out chasing us around, you sneak into his HQ and grab the data. Sound good?
Send me the coordinates, and I'll make my way there.
You got it. Before we dive into this op, I have to tell you, I feel like Balron's playing games here. Treating those creep slavers like they actually matter. Hell, playing nice with any of the locals. Boss's eyes are on more than just the mission, I'm sure of it.
Members of the Dark Council always look out for themselves at least as much as they look out for the Empire.
Balron and Shah especially. All right, I've burned enough of your time. I'll move my people into position and we'll be ready to start when you are. Amri out.
Thank you. Action, boss. Let's make this quick.
Is that better?
What in the... Nova breaks
again? Feeling a bit better now?
Thought me and my droids taught you a lesson last time.
Major Anri, I'm downloading the failsafe schematics now.
Copy that. Then we finally have the old fool locked down. Gonna snag some droids and make our getaway before he gets loose again. Anri out.
Thank you.
ready for departure. Feeling a bit better now?
Thanks to your impressive efforts, the vote has gone as we intended. Mekshar will sell fuel to the Republic. Their ships are preparing to dock now.
All without the slightest idea of our true plans. Well done. We can begin our attack as soon as their ships are locked in.
I've gone over the failsafe schematics with my boys. We'll break into the maintenance shafts and hit the four main emitters all at once. Someone else will have to throw the big switch, though. Can't activate the failsafe from inside. Has to be done from the dock's control center.
Leave that to me.
We're of the same mind. Excellent. Before you begin, I will load the remainder of our troops into assault shuttles and make a diversionary strike on the docks themselves. That should serve to distract the bulk of their defenders. Still, do be careful as you approach the failsafe controls, darling.
I don't want to see you hurt either.
Wouldn't want to spoil the victory party, after all. Oh, to see their ships gutted by the very fuel that they were so desperate to acquire. This will be a glorious day for the Empire.
A day to be exceeded only by our forthcoming victory on Corellia. Now then, everyone to your tasks. Take no prisoners, and above all else, enjoy yourselves.
Entrances.
That's it. Come and get me. Your move, Commander.
Thank you.
I've been waiting for this, Imperial. Your plan ends here.
I've reached the failsafe controls.
Emitters have all been modified. We're ready. Perfect. Activate the failsafe.
Firing now.
Forces return to base.
You made an all-out military assault on my docks! Meksha isn't Imperial territory. You don't get to ignore my rules!
It is true that our forces attacked their ships, as they do in all corners of the galaxy. But it was your council that voted to put them in that position.
And it was your weapon that shredded their ships so spectacularly.
No! They'll never think.
That we have been working together since the beginning? That is exactly what they'll think. Why else would you be meeting us now?
You have made an enemy of the Republic. Your neutrality will be meaningless.
But you are not alone in these trying times. Your affiliation with the Empire will gradually strengthen over time. I believe you could become our key refueling station in this sector, if you learn to behave.
Taking over the station wasn't our mission here.
Not our only mission, perhaps. But the Empire's logistical structure doesn't expand itself. A small deployment of troops, perhaps a warship or two, and we'll gain years of smooth and reliable operations in this sector.
Lana. I believe we're done here.
What? What about Meksha?
It's yours. Enjoy.
I take it there have been some developments.
The Republic fleet has been all but obliterated. They won't reach Corellia.
Excellent. And what of Shaar and Vauron?
Their obsession with taking control of Meksha nearly cost us everything. I did what I had to do.
As the Empress decreed, with no further Republic reinforcements to contend with, our victory on Corellia is all but guaranteed. I'm transmitting coordinates now. We will meet to discuss our strategy for the attack immediately. Malgus out.
Hey, sounds like I'm headed for Corellia too. How about...
What in the... No. You know what? I don't need to know.
Wise choice. You're just as sharp as I've heard. Are you one of the ones where I backtalk and get killed?
You think that's what got them killed? Backtalk?
Them? No, probably had to kill them just to get a word in at all.
Oh, I like this one.
I've enjoyed working with her so far. Major Anri, this is Lana Bonico.
Charmed.
I got tired of sitting around in the shuttle. So am I clear to come in here or what? Oh. One of those missions, huh?
Best not to ask, I find. If only he could help himself.
Are we good to go or what? This is not the best neighborhood.
Lead the way.
Commander, everyone else is with the fleet en route, save the Empress, of course. She's back on Dromund Kaas. I'll connect us.
Commander, I'm pleased to see you again. Allow me to apologize for any excesses you've had to address on the part of my Dark Council. They could all learn from your steadfast devotion.
Your successes against the Republic reinforcements have all but guaranteed our victory on Corellia. But we must not become overconfident.
If I'm involved, then victory is guaranteed.
Then let's not waste any time. Given that the enemy is unaware of the details of our strategy, their fleets will assume a flexible defensive formation in geosynchronous orbit above the Meridian Complex shipyard. Contrary to their expectations, I will take most of our ships to the far side of Corellia, forcing at least some of their vessels to break formation and engage us.
And how will you ensure that the enemy chases you?
Indiscriminate bombardment of the planet's surface. Cities, industrial centers, resource caches. We will be impossible to ignore.
Taking advantage of the Republic's sentimentality, they won't be able to resist.
With their formation broken, our technological advantages will allow us to punch through the remaining defenders and conduct a surface assault on the complex. The last of our dreadnoughts equipped with Isotope 5 reactors will escort the ground assault force through the enemy's blockade. Meanwhile, the silencers commanded by Moff Pyron will destroy any Republic capital ships that attempt to interfere.
You mean my silencers?
The Empire's silencers. Once we reach the planet's surface, we will attack the Meridian Complex from multiple directions, seize its control center, and disable the shields protecting it from orbital bombardment.
From there, our ships reduce the complex to slag, and the Republic's best hope for victory crumbles into dust.
An impressive and well-conceived plan. But what role will the Alliance and its incomparable commander play?
The silencers are vulnerable to starfighter attack. With the Alliance fleet to escort them, that risk is all but nullified.
As for the commander, I would welcome such a deadly ally in my surface attack group.
Let's hope you can keep up with me better than last time.
Rendezvous with these coordinates. Our attack begins as soon as you arrive, Commander.
Let our enemies remember why they fear the power of the Sith Empire. Let the entire galaxy know our strength.
My boys have a ship fueled and ready for us. They're practically drooling. Most of them have never seen a battle this big. They'll be competing for the most kills. Care to join the pool? Winner takes any interesting gear or other goodies we managed to plunder on the way out.
I'd rather win some time alone with you.
My time's not something you win. Besides, once we've hit the surface and dropped everyone who gets in our way, it'll just be the two of us, right? Shall we?
Commander, proceed to these coordinates to join our assault formation.
All ships are in position and report ready.
Let the battle begin.
Proceeding with bombardment, targeting all major population centers.
Silencer group, move to your designated firing points. Surface attack group, advance.
Isotope 5 generators at maximum output. Engines at 322%, shields at 563%.
Energy levels like that, flying this close together, our little ships will never even show up on their scopes. We're all but invisible.
They're concentrating fire! Trying to pick us off one by one!
Ignore them. Maintain course and speed.
Shields! Failing!
We have reached the Republic's defensive line.
All ships, break formation. Scatter!
They can't shoot at us now. If they miss, they'll hit their own people on the surface.
And what are we supposed to do if they don't miss?
Die, I guess. Same as any other day.
Surface attack group, proceed to your landing coordinates. The final phase of the battle is about to begin.
Than anticipated. All shuttles proceed to secondary drop zones.
Squad, you're watching our backs. Republic's gonna send everyone they've got to reinforce this shipyard, so be ready to rack up some big kill counts. Contest starts now. A point for every kill. Officers are 5, vehicles and Jedi count for 10. And if you die, you're out. So don't get reckless out there. Understood.
We won't let you down, Major.
You never do. Hop to it. Ready, Commander?
You have an interesting way of motivating your troops.
Confidence will keep a squad alive better than any armor or weapon. Gotta win in your head before you can win for real. Let's start some trouble.
Incoming!
need to get off this beach. We're sitting Banthas out here.
Hit Axial Park while we're here. Bet I could find some nice cuttings for my garden.
Approaching the main Republic defensive line. Be prepared for heavy resistance.
Thank you.
the industrial monorail that services the spire. If it is still operational, it will be the fastest way inside.
Invaders! You defile our home!
Incoming!
I'm channeling the Force into you. Let it rejuvenate you.
Thank you. Don't shoot! I'm a pacifist.
Who are you?
I'm Theron Sedrax.
Obviously.
Preeminent expert in exotechnology and senior design engineer for this facility.
Theron, huh? Bet you have a buddy named Theron.
Another Theron? He probably spells it the stupid way. Presumably, you're here to seize control of the facility? Or perhaps to sabotage the defensive systems?
Make yourself useful or you're dead.
I would love to make a grand speech about never giving up and choosing death over dishonor, but the truth is, the situation is out of my hands. All defensive systems, shields, anti-aircraft guns, and so on, have been transferred to the secondary control station near the top of the spire. All of this equipment is useless now. So there's really nothing to be accomplished here, and nothing I can help you with.
Commander.
Apparently the shield controls have been transferred to another control center, higher up in the spire.
Is that so?
None of the computers will respond, my lord, and I'm seeing some lightsaber burns over here.
That was the Jedi, Tau Adair. She's commanding the last of the facility's guards. She severed the connection as soon as control was transferred, then headed upstairs.
Then we have our target. Commander, on Ossus, we united our strength to crush the Jedi who tried to oppose the Empire. It's time we repeated that triumph. Join me, and together we will win a victory for the Empire that will change the course of the galaxy forever.
Together, we'll be unstoppable.
Major, hold this position, no matter the cost.
Yes, my lord. And what about him?
He's a useful hostage. The Republic will have to hold back if their top scientist might get caught in the crossfire.
Good thinking.
I should have stayed on Nar Shaddaa.
We'll keep you covered. Good luck up there. Moving out. Steady. Fear is a deadly weapon, but only if you let them have it.
Afraid or not, you'll die all the same.
We've got your back, Tau.
Fools. Not one of you could hope to defeat us.
You're not fighting one of us. You're fighting all of us.
Then you will all die.
We will stop.
There is more to do.
Fighting.
you are beaten. Your shipyard will be obliterated, your Republic will crumble, and your fellow Jedi will be hunted to extinction. Your destruction is inevitable.
As inevitable as gravity!
I'm disabling the shields now.
Warning! Defensive shields have been disabled. Warning!
Raven to command. The shields are down. We're evacuating now.
All ships, target the Meridian complex. Fire!
Allow me to congratulate you on a job well done. Your victory on Corellia is an incomparable testament to your value as an ally of the Empire. Rumors suggest great things are soon to come for you. Do enjoy. Any rewards are well earned.
Thank you, NRO2. I'm glad to have helped.
Farewell, Commander.
It was skillfully done, to be sure. You truly embody the finest aspects of the Sith doctrine.
Coordination and focus gave us this victory. When we fight as one united empire, we cannot fail.
Do not forget, our unity extended beyond even our own empire. Commander, you are a welcome sight. Do join us.
With their shipyard destroyed, the Republic has already retreated from countless worlds.
We've been watching in real time. Terribly entertaining.
I will develop plans to extend our lines and claim the most valuable of these territories in a matter of weeks.
It's too bad Malgus couldn't join in the victory celebrations.
His recovery will take some time, but rest assured he will return to the fold soon enough.
Wonderful.
Victory over our ancient enemies grows closer by the minute.
Don't get ahead of yourselves. We haven't won this war yet.
A fair point. We should speak in private, Commander. The rest of you are dismissed.
What did I say the last time we were in this chamber, Annabelle?
Quite unnecessary, but I suppose your help is worth the indulgence. It has become clear that the Dark Council is best suited to functions of management and cannot be fully entrusted with matters of war. The Empire needs an organization capable of rapid, decisive action, operating outside the Dark Council's purview. A group answering directly to me. My predecessor had such a group, the Hand. Though its members were insane, murderous fanatics. I will construct my own Hand, formed of the Empire's best and most loyal frontline personnel. My first choice would be to recruit the Han's initial ranks from your alliance. To have Odessen officially join the Empire and your members become full citizens. Your Sith title would be fully restored. Any of your past holdings would be yours to claim in the service of destroying our Empire's enemies. Of course, you may forego all of this and maintain your alliance's independence if you choose. I would still have you working directly with my hand rather than the Dark Council. The choice is yours. Will you return to the Empire or remain the Alliance commander?
The Empire is where I belong. The Alliance will become your hand, and I will be a Lord of the Sith once more.
Welcome home, Darth Nox. I will begin the necessary preparations at once. In Malgus's absence, I will have to find another suitable liaison. I look forward to seeing the results of our new relationship. Farewell.
Care. The body count is too high.
This is war. Deaths are inevitable.
I don't believe that. Krovos made a choice. And that's the team we're on now.
Theron?
I know you didn't pull the trigger on all those civilians, but you're supporting the people who did. I want to trust you. But it doesn't seem like we can trust them.
A spy really should be more flexible. I've made arrangements for a bit of redecorating on Odessen, but it will take some time before we're issued enough banners, uniforms, and so on. But that can all wait, I suppose. I'm told there's quite a raucous party up in the officers' lounge. Would you care to be the star guest?
Sounds like fun. Let's go.
It's just this way.
Hey. Thanks again for finding me that bottle.
Of course. If you need anyone to share it,
count on it. Mind if I borrow him a minute?
I'll find you later.
Pretty crazy stuff, huh? Ossus wasn't even that long ago, and we've already made it through so much. That's war, I suppose. Still, most grunts aren't lucky enough to work with the deadliest fighter in the entire galaxy. Which reminds me, too bad you didn't join the bet. You'd have won for sure.
How about that time alone we were talking about?
Gonna have to wait, I'm afraid. I actually came to talk about something else. Back on Corellia, I didn't actually make it out with the rest of the shuttles. Got caught under some falling debris and all the chaos. I wouldn't have made it out at all if they hadn't lent me a hand.
Who?
A fellow Sith.
You're the one who tried to kill me on Mech Shah.
Don't take it personally.
It was a test. Nothing more.
A test you actually passed.
What are you talking about?
I am Lord Scourge, once a loyal servant of the Empire.
Kira Carson, Jedi Knight. Not thrilled to be here.
All three of us have fought the same enemy. The former Sith Emperor, Tenebrae, Vitiate, Valkorion, whatever you wish to call him. We know he was once a part of you. And we both felt his destruction, but he has always been a master of deceit. We had to be sure that he wasn't lingering in your mind, hidden, waiting to come out only in the most dire circumstances. Now, we are sure.
I don't see Jedi and Sith cooperating very often outside of my alliance. How did you end up working together?
That is a very long story.
We can't risk saying more here. Let's travel to your base on Odessen. It should be safe for us to talk there.
About what?
The final, gruesome weapon of Tenebrae.
What a mess.
I have removed all compromised components. Where shall we begin repairs?
Checking the failsafe is always first. Empress Asena had us double the explosive charges after the Osus mission. It was a real pain to hook up.
Yes, I examined the device after removing it. Highly complex.
You removed it? What are you thinking?
It was rendered inoperable due to damage. Replacement is required. Interestingly, it was the only damage not caused by crushing impacts. The exterior perimeter was actually cut by a high heat implement.
Oh no.
Give me the droid. And a ship.
Hello.